All right, guys, it is 2021 now. 2021 doesn't really roll off the tongue yet. It always takes a couple months to get used to it, but haven't posted many YouTube videos this year so far, but me and Hunter's back, ready to get everything rolling again. You know, we're going to be posting a lot more content coming up. Got a little bit burnout on it. Had to take a little bit of a break, but now we're back in the saddle. We're rigging the boat this week, building about 15 rods for a head down for the first Bassmaster Elite Series on St. John's. So if you want to follow the journey, go ahead and subscribe right now. Turn the alerts on so you don't miss any videos. But I'm going to take today, and what I wanted to show y'all was the sponsors that I have lined up for 2021 and kind of the baits that I'm going to be leaning on the most, because I get a ton of questions about the rods, the reels, the baits, you know, everything that I use throughout the year. And for all the people that are loyal and that are still watching, I'm going to go ahead and answer those for y'all right now because I've seen the questions. So I'm going to just jump into it right now. Obviously, the clothes I'm wearing, Striker, I'm staying with Striker this year. If y'all did not see the last video about the wintertime baits, Striker has a pretty cool program right now for local club tournaments. If you have a local club, or if you're a president of a local club that has an AOI championship, go to strikerbrands.com and fill out the tournament rewards. You can get discounts for everybody in your club, and whoever wins the angler of the year in your small local club can actually get a Striker rain suit package. So pretty cool, staying with Striker again for this year. Obviously, another question I've been getting a ton is what boat I'll be running, because a lot of people obviously are not staying with Ranger for the 2021 season. I am staying Ranger. I'm staying the exact same boat that I had last year. And the reason for that is, just tell y'all the truth, I couldn't get a boat deal that I felt like was, you know, good enough for me to justify having to sell this one, get a new one, and rig it in time, because we had a very short off season. I don't want to put myself under that time constraint. So I just decided I'll keep the boat. It's a new Ranger with a 4-stroke Mercury on it. There's nothing wrong with it at all. So I'm gonna go catch me hopefully another 10-pounder in this same exact boat this year. So hooks, stuff like that, that's one of the most vital parts. I'm going with Gamakatsu hooks this year. I was sponsored by Gamakatsu and Spro for the last half of last year. And this year right here, I'm gonna be back with Gamakatsu. I'm gonna be using the Gamakatsu boxes. Y'all see these in the videos. This is something I've just started using in the past 6 or 8 months, and I really, really like them. And I'm gonna show y'all the hook right now. Y'all know I used to use the Trocar TK-130. You know, I used that when I first started doing the YouTube videos. Now I'm using the Gamakatsu heavy cover flipping hook, and I'm gonna show you that right now, because it's a very pretty hook, made out of a little bit better quality steel than the other one I was using. So just in my opinion, this is the flipping hook. This is the one I used the last half of the year, Santee Cooper, Gunnersville, all those places. Can you see it? Pretty hook with it's got a 10 keeper on it, 4-aught heavy wire. That's the one that I'm flipping now with my D-bombs. So that's the hooks that I'm throwing. Whenever I get a little bit more technique specific, I'll show y'all the hook that actual day. But for right now, that's the hook that I flip with. Y'all know I'm a big time flipper. I flip a ton. So that's the main hook I'm gonna be throwing. And then obviously I'll dial it in a little bit more. Another really, really cool thing that I showed in another video from Gamakatsu, they have this foam slit case like this right here that I keep all my treble hooks in, all my Gamakatsu treble hooks in. A really, really cool addition. It's going to be a lot more organized in the boat. I'm going to leave this entire treble hook thing in the boat, and I'm going to, you know, be able to find it extremely quickly. And as y'all can see, I had to get all new boxes, so I had to get all new High Waters Creations tackle tags. See, I got them on this one. I got them right here on this one. The old ones I had lasted me literally 5 or 6 years on the same exact boxes. First time I've changed boxes in years, so I had to get me a new set of tackle tags. Now, that being said, I've had the same boxes ever since me and Hunter got together a long, long time ago. So obviously y'all already know the frogs I've been using forever is the Spro frogs. The one that I use the majority of the time is the Spro Poppin' Frog. Here's just a generic black one. That's just the all-around go-to color is black. So I've been using that same frog forever. I've never kept that from y'all. That's the frog I always use. Caught so many giants on this frog, and hopefully on St. John's we'll catch a couple more on it. One thing that I have used sporadically off and on, but have not used an absolute ton, is the Spro crankbaits. I've definitely caught a lot of fish on the Little John, but I haven't thrown it nearly as much as I should have, because it's a very, very powerful bait. So it's just, everybody knows the Spro Little John's a good bait, especially in the wintertime. Let me find one that I can actually get out right here. That's not a secret color. Here's a red and orange one. That's just a standard Spro Little John. Gamakatsu hooks come stock on it. But here's the one that I've been throwing the most recently. This is the Spro Fat Papa 55 square bill. It's got a microchip bill. It's still, you know, it's a really, really pretty square bill. It hunts a lot. It's got a really good action. So that's the easiest. That's the one that's made my transition the easiest. This is a crankbait that I have started to really, really catch them on, and I really, really like this thing. So Spro crankbaits are going to be the main thing I'm throwing as far as crankbaits go. Not going to hold anything from y'all though. Like if I'm catching on a different brand, I'll tell y'all. So now I showed y'all the hook that I'm flipping D-bombs in, and that comes straight to the next one. I signed with Missile Baits officially for the next year. Y'all already know how much I flip a D-bomb. Y'all see it in all my videos. I've been flipping a D-bomb for years and years and years. So our absolute go-to flipping bait. Everybody knows it. Here's a pack of Bruiser Flash Missile Baits D-bomb. I caught a 10 pounder on this exact same one last year in the Bassmaster Elite Series. And the thing about all the baits that I used last year, a lot of y'all know this, but I didn't have a ton of sponsors for last year as far as baits went specifically. So every single bag of soft plastics, every single hard bait, every single frog, all the hooks, everything that I had to buy, I paid for it myself last year. So I got to use exactly what I wanted to use. We had a good year last year, and I didn't sign any bad deals because I didn't want to promote products I didn't 100% believe in. So I held out for a year, and now I got to partner with the companies that I actually wanted to. Like, if you asked me which companies I wanted to partner with, it would obviously be Missile because I throw their stuff the most, and I throw Spro and Gamakatsu stuff the absolute most as well. So I held out for a year, and it really worked out. Super happy I did that. I wasn't already obligated to another company that I'm not as loyal to. Now, as far as the D-bombs go, here's another one. These are going to be some colors that y'all have not seen before. Pretty interesting here. This one is called Wicked Gill. And the cool thing about this is exclusive colors. You can't get these just everywhere. You can't go online to your favorite retailer and just get these from all of them. These are completely exclusive colors. Let me pull a couple of these out of the bag because I've never seen these colors before. And now that I've got access to all the Missile Baits, I could probably get them, but I've also teamed up with Tournament Tackle, and a really cool thing that Tournament Tackle does is they offer all of your favorite baits that you normally use, all the Missile Baits and stuff like that you already use. They offer them in bulk for cheaper prices. So if you want to go in there and look for baits that you already use, you can order 25 or 30 packs of baits. We normally only get them in 10, but the really cool thing that made me the most excited is they offer these exclusive colors, like these two right here, that you can only get from tournamenttackle.com. So that's a really, really cool deal, and I'm gonna be like the only guy on the elites that have some of these colors. So that's pretty cool to me, and it's also pretty awesome to see some off the wall colors like this that looks like it'll actually get bit with a little bit different shades of blue and some stuff like that. So really, really excited about partnering with that, and I would be lying if I didn't tell y'all that this was my absolute favorite thing to fish with. If y'all don't know this by now, I've been talking these things up forever. I absolutely love my Point Blank and Fuji rods. If y'all ever see me on the lake, I've said this for a couple years now, come over and say, Kyle, let me see what that 7.3 medium heavy feels like. Let me see what that 7.6 flip of steel feels like. Every time I pick one of these up without a reel on it, it literally blows my mind. I'll be using Point Blank rod blanks again. I'll be building them all myself. Fuji rod components, Fuji cork, Fuji hook keeper, Fuji guides all the way, titaniums on all my fluorocarbon rods, and steel alkanites on all of my braided fishing rods. So that is the rods and reels I'll be using for next year. Super excited about that. Again, really cool to work with a company like that. Like after I've used them for all last year, that's the only rods I want to use. Every time I pick up a rod in a store, I'm like, man, how did I ever fish with that kind of stuff? So I'm really excited to be able to continue that relationship with them and keep fishing with the rods that I think are the best. So as y'all know, we have a Signature Series jig coming out. It's going to be out. We hit a little bit of a delay coming from the factory that is poured in, but hopefully it'll be out in a couple of weeks, February the 1st, February the 4th, something like that. We're hoping, fingers crossed, we've already got the skirts in. We're just waiting on the finished product of the heads to come in, but I'm staying with Untamed Tackle again next year. You can see this right here is a Punisher swim jig that I was throwing just the other day. This is a pretty bluegill colored one. One of the prettiest colors we have, but the fish seem to like a black and blue and a white swim jig a little bit better, at least in my opinion. It's got a super stout 5-0 hook in it. And I'll be coming out with my Signature Series Ace jig also coming out very, very soon. So staying with Untamed Tackle again. Now, I hope I did not miss anybody. Okay, so one thing that I did last year is I paid for a ton of fishing line all throughout the year. Every time I got done a tournament, I would go online and I'd order more fluorocarbon line because last year I was using K9 braid. I never used K9 fluorocarbon, because I really, really liked their braid, their fluorocarbon. I didn't like quite as much. So I always ordered Sunline fishing line last year. I just ordered it off the internet for as cheap as I could get it. And I would order the 600 yard spools. So we have partnered with Sunline fishing line for this next year. I'll be using all shooter fluorocarbon. And then the X-Plasma Asagi braid, I think it's called. I don't know, it's a Japanese word. I don't really know exactly how to pronounce it. I'm gonna have to get the official pronunciation up, but I've been fishing with it for a few weeks now, probably even over a month now, and really, really like it. So Sunline officially for next year. And I hope I remembered everybody. TX Marine, yep. Oh, power pole for sure. I don't even know how you could go a year without fishing with power pole. I'm glad Hunter caught that one. You know, you take them, you really do, you take your power poles for granted. They take a ton of abuse, they stop the boat, they hold you in place, and then you kind of just put it back there and you don't worry about it at all. We'll have the power pole charge system in there, have Dakota lithium batteries in the boat, the power pole charge.
Shoot. Save your butt one time.
Save my butt. The power pole charged last year on St. Clair. Literally, I forgot to plug my boat up after a day of fishing a Bassmaster Elite Series event. Day one, I didn't even plug my boat up. Day two, my batteries were on like 18%. I plugged them in, went and got breakfast, came back, hooked the boat up, and went to the lake. My batteries were on 28%. I let them idle for 45 minutes, and my batteries didn't go dead all day on St. Clair in the current. Unbelievable. It saved my butt big time. So power pole, obviously I'm gonna have the Mercury 4-Stroke Pro XS again. I'm in a Ranger 520L, Dakota lithium batteries, the power pole charge. Everything's cool for next year. We're ready to rock and roll. I'm so excited to go. I think that's it. We miss anything, Hunter?
I don't think so.
I think we got them all. All the sponsors for next year. So hope I answer a ton of those questions. Y'all know exactly what I'm using. And whenever I'm using it, if you see me using a fluorocarbon, it's gonna be a shooter, stuff like that. So just wanna give y'all a generic breakdown of the sponsors that are coming in for next year. And I'm super excited to be partnered with them. Let's get this 2021 season started. Do it now?
Do you want to see a rigging?
Do y'all want to see a rigging vlog? I'm about to add 3 more graphs to this boat. I'm going to have some precision sonar mounts on here. Everything's going to be good. We're going to rig it up this week. If y'all want to see that, give me a like, leave a thumbs up, and leave me a comment down below. And if you want to keep up with the journey, hit the subscribe button and turn the alerts on. We'll see y'all in the next video.